Hey guys, Res here from NIP, and today I'm gonna do a little segment called Ask NIP. So I'm gonna answer some questions that you guys sent to me, around 15 questions, so here we go. First question from Felix Andersson. What games do you play other than CSGO? Recently I only played a game called, or only game besides CSGO, called Battalion. It's pretty similar to CSGO. It's like a, like bomb defusal FPS game, and it's really fun and really entertaining. Like if you want to, if I want to like take a break from CSGO, I just go to that game pretty much right now. But there's always new games coming up, like Outer Chesses, and that's fun as well. So I'm pretty diverse, and I try to play everything. Another question from Calibage. Were you nervous when you first met Forrest and Getright? A little bit, yes. At the beginning, yes, when I was like seeing them for the first time, and I've never seen them before, like maybe once when I played them once pretty much on LAN, I think, and that was in Remac, and that's the only time I met them, I think. Other than that, like when I first met them, it got like they were really nice and really friendly, so the nervousness came over pretty quickly when I got to know them. So like, yeah, we became friends really fast, and that's a good thing. Another question from Ebbe Cedermarker. How did you get discovered as an upcoming talent? I think Epsilon was the first organization that discovered me, so to speak. Mostly because I qualified for the minor in, it was PGL Bucharest. That was my first minor, and I went there with a team called Cringe Gods together with Draken, and that's where Epsilon decided to pick us up, and yeah, that's pretty much how my career started, and that's why and how NIP found me pretty much. So I would say, if you want any tips to like become discovered, I would say try to qualify for a minor, and that is tough, but that's the like easiest part to get discovered by organization as a new team. A question from Nick HIL. In what extent has life changed after joining NIP? So I think it's fairly different from Epsilon. And yeah, of course, the life before I was a professional, mostly because there's a lot of traveling right now, and there's a lot of stuff to do, like this. And yeah, I'm pretty much on the move all the time, and yeah, like, and I'm not complaining. I'm having a blast, and it's a lot of fun, and I'm doing what I love. But that's probably the most life-changing part. Like I'm doing a lot of stuff right now, and before I was just home playing CS and just chilling, but now I'm chilling everywhere pretty much, so that's it. A very clever question from Oliver Campbell. What is your current resolution? I believe it's I switched back to 1280 by 960 stretched, and I played it for a while now, and but I switched recently to, what was it now? I think it was like 1280 by 800, but I played for that like a few weeks, and then I switched back to 960. So I'm back on 1280, 960. A question from Sproho. What is your favorite skin? If I'm gonna pick a skin that I have, like my favorite, it would be my knife, actually, because I got it very recent. It's a Talon knife, Slaughter. I think it came in the newest collection of cases, like the Talon. and it's a really cool knife. I think it's the coolest knife in the game right now. And to complement it, I picked the coolest skin as well, the Slaughter, and it looks really good. A question from NR Ezbrina. When did you start playing CS? I think, I'm not 100% sure, but I think I started playing around when I was 8 or 9. That's where my brother decided to introduce me to the game, I think. I think 8 or 9, and I never left my hands off it. The only game I didn't play or switch to was World of Warcraft, and that was just like a few years maybe, and then I switched back to Counter-Strike. So I always came back to Counter-Strike, actually, even ever since I saw it. So Jake asks, have you ever broken anything in rage while playing CS? No, I haven't, and I think I will never do it. I feel like I can't really reach the part where you get so angry or enraged to break something. I feel like I can't reach that moment pretty much, and I'm glad I can't. Musa Gurbani asked me, what is your favorite map? My favorite map right now is, I would say it's the map I've always liked, and it's always been my favorite, and it's Overpass. I feel like I always do well on it, and I like it. It's so, probably because it's so diverse, and like I can pretty much do a lot of stuff on my own without like risking to break the like team structure or anything. Like everything works hand in hand, but it's really easy to manipulate how the opponents play, pretty much. It's hard to explain, but I think it's really fun to play it. That's my favorite map for sure. And Andre Rodriguez, maybe. What is your secret to stay calm during big events, considering your age? I have no secret. I would say it's just experience now, pretty much. Because when I started playing on the big stages, maybe like my first big stage was in Cologne, and that I was so nervous, and as well as Oakland, I was shaking pretty much, and it's pretty, yeah, like when I got experience, like when I played on all these stages, I just became more calm and more relaxed, and now I don't really get that nervous anymore, because I'm pretty much used to it. So it takes time. Okay, a question from Benteson. How many hours a day do you prac? We practice usually around 7 to 8 hours. I think that's the most common time every team practice nowadays. And it's usually like 3 pracs, and then you have a break for lunch or dinner, and then you have 3 more pracs. So yeah, pretty much 6 to 7 hours, I would say. And that's, if you play more than that, you can get really like drained and tired. So we try to keep into that schedule pretty much. And that's all the questions. Thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video. And if you have any more questions, just hit me up in DM and maybe I'll answer you.